Hello, Belgrad. I'm Irit Shamgar from Tel Aviv, and I would like to tell you about my film, God Deserves a House. The film tells about a group of people who want to build a house for God on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem. The main characters are four Aharonov sisters, Rina, Tzipora, Batya, and Yael. The sisters believe in a sacred cause. They ascend the Temple Mount time after time with the aim of rebuilding the Holy Temple, where now stands the Dome of the Rock and three mosques. Despite the opposition of family, friends, neighbors, the Israeli legal authorities, the chief rabbis, most of the Israelis and Palestinians alike, and all the Muslims in all the country around, the sisters are determined to hasten the building of the third temple. These educated career women take time from their busy schedule to facilitate the change. They collect worms to dye the curtain of the Ark of Covenant, weave linen from the priestly garments, and donate the rings to cast the golden menorah in the temple. The contradictions in their life are fascinating. While they are loving, devoted mothers to their children, they take them to most dangerous places. They see themselves as stray, blazing pioneers, but live within a strict Orthodox framework while liberating for themselves a place of freedom within it. In my travels with the sisters during 5 years, I alternate between feelings of empathy and repulsion. The nationalism frightens me. I find the messianic view threatening. On the other hand, they are all educated feminists, and their personal deeds manifest independence and courage. I fell in love with their willingness to follow their belief all the way, even though I am truly convinced that their path will build destruction upon all of us if they succeed. In conclusion, it seems there are more questions now than answers. I hope that after seeing the film, each and every one of you will formulate its own opinion and have its own ideas. So thank you, all of you. Hope you enjoy the film and see you next time when the corona is over. Bye-bye, Belgrade.